In this video, I'll help you understand how to read the annual report of a company. When it comes to fundamental analysis, the annual report is where all the action happens. So you as a fundamental analyst should be extremely comfortable reading the annual report of a company. I'll take the example of Bajaj Auto and help you understand how to read the annual report of that company. We'll start by downloading the annual report of Bajaj Auto. There are various places from which you can download the annual report of a company, but I would recommend you visit the company's website, check the investor section, and download the annual report from the investor section. As you can see, I'm in the investor section of Bajaj Auto's website, and I'm downloading the annual report for the year 2020-2021. The annual report is an elaborate document which includes all the relevant information to the company. This can include both financial and non-financial information. For you as a fundamental analyst, some parts of the annual report is useful and some parts of it is not so useful. So you should know which ones to use when you're skimming through the annual report of a company. Most annual reports follow a similar structure, especially for companies that have been around for a while. As you can see, these are the contents of the annual report. From this report, the main things that I would look at would be the management discussion and analysis, the shareholder information, and the consolidated financial statements. The management discussion and analysis section in the annual report is one of the most important sections. This is where you get insights into the business strategy of the company, the growth prospects of the company, and the risks that the company faces. Usually, the management discussion and analysis starts with a note on how the economy has fared, followed by how the sector has performed. As you can see, Bajaj Auto has also included financial highlights in management discussion and analysis. This is something you can ignore for now. The company here discusses the various products it manufactures, bikes in this case, and it also helps us understand the different segment classification of these bikes. As you can see, Bajaj Auto here has a M segment, which stands for the mileage segment. It has a SS segment, which stands for the super sport segment. And it also has the KTM and the pro biking segment. It is important to know the segments as it will eventually help us understand which segment drives the revenue of the company. Now, here's an interesting bit in the annual report. The company talks about the reincarnation of Chetak, a scooter brand that we are all familiar with. You, as a fundamental analyst, will probably conclude that the future revenue growth of the company may come from Chetak. Now, this is a piece of information which won't be available to you in the financial statements of the company. Finally, Bajaj also discusses the R&D pipeline from which you can identify the potential future growth drivers of the company. If it is a manufacturing company that you're looking at, then the annual report will also have information about all the plants that it has. Now, this information will come handy when you're trying to calculate the capacity utilization of all these plants. The annual report also gives you a list of all the subsidiaries the company has. This is a good to know information as it will give you a sense of all the sectors it operates in and also the geographies it is present in. Also, do pay attention to the corporate governance of the company as it will help you understand who the directors of the company are, their background, remuneration, and the shareholding in the company. The annual report also has a section in which the company discusses details about the share price of the company. Now, I've seen a lot of investors spend a lot of time in this part of the annual report, which is utterly useless. I would suggest you skip this because end of the day, you're dealing with the company's business here and not the stock price. The annual report also has a section called the director's report. Now, again, this is a section that you can feel free to skip because we would be dealing with the financials at a later point anyway. Finally, the last section of the annual report is the consolidated financial statements of the company. Now, when it comes to the financial statements, there are two types of financial statements, the standalone financial statement and the consolidated financial statement. I would recommend you always deal with the consolidated financial statement as it includes the finances of the subsidiary companies as well. Now, before you read the consolidated financial statement of a company, there is an independent auditor's report at the beginning. I would suggest you give it a quick read to understand if there are any changes to the accounting policy for the given year. I've seen that investors take the financial statements from third-party websites. I would suggest you don't do that. Take the data directly from the annual report, as this is the single source of truth for the company. In the next video, we'll try and understand how to read the financial statements of the company, which includes the balance sheet, profit and loss, and the cash flow statement. Key takeaways from this video are: